Well, this is a big year for construction projects in the city of Spokane. There are 43 capital projects happening around the city. That amounts to about $73 million. So like I said, there's a lot going on and a lot to be excited about. So here's a quick look at what's going on around the city this 2015 construction season. This year, there are 8 combined sewer overflow or CSO projects aimed at improving the health of the Spokane River, 6 sidewalk projects, 17 street projects, 3 trail projects, 6 water projects, and 1 storm sewer restoration and bridge inspection project. Street maintenance work, which involves grind and overlay, crack seal, and pothole repair, will also be ongoing throughout the season. Along Northwest Boulevard, crews are building a buried concrete tank beneath Northwest Boulevard at about Providence Avenue. The tank, called CSO6, will be about 250 feet long and 50 feet wide. It'll help temporarily store combined storm and sanitary sewage so that the sewage won't spill into the river during a storm or rapid snowmelt. Other CSO projects this year include CSO 12 on Nora Avenue to TJ Minock Drive and CSO 20 near High Drive and Hatch Road. We mentioned that there are 3 trail projects happening this construction season. One getting a lot of attention is the Ben Burr Trail. This project will leave a paved trail for bicyclists and pedestrians that will be lighted in some places. The existing gravel trail section between Liberty Park and Underhill Park will also be improved. Work on the Ben Burr Trail runs from Centennial Trail to Ben Burr and from 5th Avenue to the trail. The city's street projects aren't just about repaving the road, but involve improvements in a number of areas above and below the surface. For example, that means the city's engineers look at stormwater management, sewer needs, and water main replacement, among other things, in addition to fixing the street. That's an approach that saves taxpayers time and money, so crews don't have to cut into a road they just repaved the year before because pipes needed to be fixed. There are street projects happening all over the city this year. One of the major projects is happening in the Southgate neighborhood on South Havana Street. The improvements are part of a larger project to install a water main within the street, which will continue south in Glen Rose Road beyond the city limits. This has also become a pilot project for new ways to address stormwater runoff, including porous asphalt bike lanes that will help reduce stormwater runoff and pollutants. Workers will also rehab the street pavement and add sidewalks and new curb alignment. Another project that has to do with water main replacement is on the other end of town, on Panorama Drive in the 5 Mile neighborhood. Workers will replace the main and repave the entire street. Staying on the north side, the city begins the first phase of work on Rowan Avenue this year, from Driscoll to Monroe. There will be new bike lanes and water lanes, and crews will fill gaps in the sidewalk as they replace the roadway. The first phase of work also begins on Indiana Avenue from Division Street to Dakota. Road replacement will accompany a lane configuration to 1 lane in each direction, and that will also include bike lanes. Next year, the work will be extended east on Indiana to Perry. And speaking of Perry Street, phase 2 and 3 of Riverside Drive, also known as MLK Way, will be happening from Sherman Street to Perry Street. This project will construct a new road on new alignment. The road will have 2 traffic lanes, 2 bike lanes, curb and sidewalk, and storm drainage. Not too far away from the Riverside Drive project in the downtown area and the lower South Hill, road work is set for the Lincoln Monroe Street couplet from 8th Avenue to Main. Crews will use a thicker section of rock base and asphalt for this roadway. They'll use concrete on Monroe from 7th to 4th Avenues to provide some added durability on that steep hill, which sees its fair share of wear and tear during the winter months. The project will also include new curbs in some areas, pedestrian lighting, and ADA accessible curb ramps. Major work was done on Lincoln Monroe Streets last year too, just like on High Drive, where the second phase of that big project is kicking off this year. Last year saw High Drive completed from 29th to Bernard. This year, the project calls for work from Bernard to Hatch Road. This project includes pavement reconstruction, storm sewer facilities, a CSO tank, swales, and a water main replacement. This project is also about beautifying one of Spokane's most popular spots and making it even more accessible for walkers, joggers, and cyclists. That means sidewalks and a planting strip on the bluff side and a continuation of bike lanes on both sides of the street. Another project with beautification in mind is the Division Street Gateway project. This spot between 3rd and 4th Avenues is one of the main gateways into our city from Interstate 90. It offers a first an often lasting impression of Spokane for visitors to our city. So when the project is finished, you'll see things like colorful plantings, artwork, pedestrian lighting, and trees that will really make this gateway shine and help make a great first impression of our city for hundreds of thousands of tourists, residents, business travelers, and potential investors. The city works hard to minimize disruptions to traffic and businesses, but it's a good idea to keep up to date with construction projects, road closures, and detour routes. Check out our weekly obstruction notice for the latest information. While you're in the streets section of SpokaneCity.org, just click on notices to get to that. You can also follow us on Twitter, Facebook, and Instagram. Look for the hashtag Spokane Streets to check out projects highlighted every week on the city's social media platforms, as well as right here on City Cable 5. And remember, businesses are open during construction, so please keep visiting your favorite shops and supporting them, even if it takes a little extra time to get there.